Suppose a swim team earned 136 points at a recent meet. The team placed in 20 events. They placed second in as many events as they placed first and third combined. A first place finish earned 10 points, a second place finish earned 6 points, and a third place finish earned 2 points. What was the distribution of medals? That is, how many firsts, seconds, and thirds? Those are our unknowns. So let's declare some variables right away. I will let F equal the number of first place finishes, and I'll let S equal the number of second place finishes. And T, then, will represent the number of third-place finishes. Now let's build some equations. Right off the bat, we're told that they placed in 20 events. So let's write that. The number of first-place medals plus the number of second-place medals plus the number of third-place medals equals 20. We're also told that they earned 136 points total, and they got 10 points for a first, 6 points for every second, and 2 points for every third. So 10 points times the number of firsts plus 6 points times the number of seconds plus 2 points times the number of thirds will equal that grand total of 136. Finally, we're told that they placed second in as many events as they placed first and third combined. So the second place, the number of second place finishes equals the number of first place finishes plus the number of third place finishes. And I wrote it over here because I know we're going to have to manipulate to get it in that order of FST constant. So let's subtract F and subtract T, and then we'll get negative F plus S, positive S was already on that left-hand side. We'll also subtract T from each side, so minus T equals 0. We have nothing left on that right-hand side. All right, let's take the coefficients and the constants and build our augmented matrix. So we have 1, 1, 1, 20, right across the first row. Second row, we have 10, 6, 2, 136. Third row, negative 1, 1, negative 1, and 0. We've got our augmented matrix, and now let's do what we need to get a 1 in the top left corner. That's already there. Great. Now what do we need to do to get a 0 on the 10, where the 10 and the negative 1 are? That is the rest of this column. Well, remember, we can do some manipulations on the rows. That is, for this next step to get 10, we want to add negative 10. So we're going to say negative 10 times row 1 plus row 2 will replace row 2. And we can just add row 1 and row 2 to get a 0 in that lower left-hand corner. So I'll just say row 1 plus row 3 will replace row 3. And the result then, first row is not changed, 1, 1, 1, 20. The second row, negative 10 times 1 plus positive 10 is 0. Negative 10 times 1 plus 6 is 4. Negative 10 times 1 plus 2 is negative 8. And this should be negative 4 here because we have negative 10 plus 6 is negative 4. And negative 200, that's negative 10 times 20, plus 136 gives you negative 64. Next row, R1 plus R3. So adding all of these plus all the numbers in the bottom row. And that gives you 0. 1 plus 1 is 2. 1 plus negative 1 is another 0. 20 plus 0 is 20. All right, moving along, we have our matrix there. I better move this down a little bit just to see if I can squeeze one more matrix in there. I think I can. Okay, we want a 1 right here where this negative 4 is. So I'm going to say negative 1/4 times row 2 will replace row 2. So we're doing this very systematically. The first row stays the same. The second row, we're multiplying by negative 1/4. So that's 0, 1. Negative 1/4 times negative 8 is positive 2. Negative 1/4 times negative 64 is positive 16. Third row, we didn't mess with it. So we'll write it as it was. Okay, now we have the 1 here in the right smack dab in the middle. We want the zeros on the rest of the column. So what do you have to add to 1 to get 0? Well, that's negative 1. So we multiply this by negative 1. Negative, let's change the color here. Negative R2, row 2, plus row 1 will replace row 1. And what do we have to, well, we have to add a negative 2 onto this 2, so negative 2 times row 2, negative 2 times this 1, plus row 3 will replace row 3. Okay, taking that up all the way to the top, because we are going to need all of this room. We get, as a result, we get 1, 0, negative 1, 4. That is, we were just adding the opposite of all this stuff. So the opposite of 2, negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1. And negative 16 plus 20 is positive 4. All right. Next row, row 2, we did not change. We didn't replace, that is. We did not replace row 2. Row 3, we're going to multiply everything in row 2 by negative 2 and then add that to row 3. So the result is 0, 0, negative 2 times 2 is negative 4, plus this 0 is negative 4. Negative 2 times 16 is negative 32 plus 20 is then negative 12. All right, we're almost there. We need a 1 here where this negative 4 is. Let's do that by multiplying this by the reciprocal. Negative 1/4 times row 3 will replace row 3. And we get as a result, I better write this a little smaller. First and second rows were not affected. So I'm just going to rewrite those. And the third row becomes 0, 0, 1. Negative 1/4 times negative 12 is a positive 3. We are very close. Very close now. What should we do here to get zeros at this negative 1 and 2 location? We can just add row 3 and row 1, because 1 plus negative 1 is 0. Row 3 plus row 1 replaces row 1. And to get rid of the 2 here, we have to add a negative 2. So negative 2 times row 3. Negative 2 times row 3 plus row 2 replaces row 2. If you feel like I'm going very quickly, you can always pause, stop, and rewind. That's the wonderful thing about video. I know I'm going a little bit fast just in order to fit this in a nice time constraint. So we have left 1, 0, 0. Now, We're adding 3 plus 4, that gives us 7. And then the second row, 0, 1, negative 2 times 1 plus 2 gives us 0. Negative 2 times 3 plus 16, that's negative 6 plus 16 gives us 10. And then 0, 0, 1, 3, we did not change row 3 on that one. And look at that. We ended up with F. This is, just to save some space here, I've got F equals 7, and S equals 10, and T, oops, let's put that in the right spot, T equals 3. So I can say we had 7 first place finishes, we had 10 second place finishes, and we had 3 third place finishes. So there is our final answer. We used the matrix to solve that system of equations and that word problem.